welcome. I'm Monica Rea, and today we're going to talk about how I made this super cute festive holiday dress. So it was actually inspired by one of Minnie's winter ensembles, which, by the way, I absolutely love the majority of her park outfits, like these. But Minnie has like some super cute winter outfits, like here's some of my favorites.
That is so fetch.
So ever since they dropped the 2023 winter looks for Mickey and Minnie, I think this is for Disneyland, I absolutely love it. So I wanted to create a dress with a similar style, and it just so happens that the perfect occasion has come up for such a dress. My beautiful baby Gabby has her winter recital coming up, as in it's tomorrow. So I'm gonna attempt to create this dress so she can wear it to the recital. And I have a lot of work ahead of me, so let's get started.
So the fabrics that we're using are flannels and then the crushed velvet. And then I have these cute little pom-poms to go around the outer skirt. So here's the design. This is what we're going for. So we'll just put that up there. So we're going to be using McCall's 7221, and it's essentially a mesh up between A and C, and of course with the inspiration of Minnie's outfit. So from view A, I'm just going to be extending the yoke to the waist, and then from view C, we're going to keep those sleeves and the bottom ruffle that it has, even though I won't be using the actual pattern piece for the bottom ruffle, but just for the aesthetic of it, we're gonna keep that because it's cute. So for the rest of the dress, we're gonna do a little off-roading. Nothing too crazy. In order to make the bodice for the dress, I needed to combine pattern pieces of the yoke and also a portion of the gown. So that way I can connect the armhole, or at least it would, you know, fit the sleeve that I'm gonna use. So here I'm just modifying the patterns to make the bodice. And of course I did the same thing for the back as well. Okay, so now that I've gotten the bodice pretty much done and everything, I realized that I do not have Gabby's measurements. So I don't know how long to make the skirt. Which the skirts are just gonna be basic rectangles anyway, so I mean it's not that big of a deal, and I don't want to cut fabric and waste it just in case it happens to be too long or if it's too short, what have you. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and work on cutting a bunch of 2-inch strips and a bunch, like maybe 4 strips, 2 inches of the velvet for the bottom ruffle, and then I'm gonna work on the sleeves as well. And after I get them from school, then I'll be able to get her measurements and start on the skirts and stuff, but yeah.
Now I'm just gonna pin the bodice pieces in place.
So with the bodice, I wanted to make sure that all the pieces lined up properly with the printed pattern on the fabric. So I took a little extra time to make sure that things were lined up.
So at this point, I had to take a break to go ahead and pick up my babies from school.
All right, I need to take your measurements, okay?
Okay.
So to make sure that I got the length of the skirt just right, I just put the bodice up against her so I have a better idea of where the waistline will be in proportion to the ultimate length of the skirt. I measured from her waistline down to about a little lower than her mid-calf, and then there will be that extra 2 inches from the bottom ruffle. I didn't want it to be too long because I know that she'll be walking upstairs to get onto the stage, and she'll probably be using both of her hands to hold the violin and bow, so yeah. We're gonna move along and get back to completing the bodice. So I put some interfacing on the edges near the center front because that's where the 2 buttons are gonna be. So I'm gonna go ahead and pin this together and sew along the center front line, or you know, around that edge. Front of the bodice is going to be lined essentially. All right, so I added some notches to the curve because that will obviously like help the fabric lay flat around the curve and it won't pull on the fabric. And so I'm gonna go ahead and press this just so it's nice and crisp. And then I'm gonna go ahead and top stitch it. Like this. So now it's time to go ahead and attach the back. For the back neckline, I just folded in on itself and stitched it down. And then went ahead and moved on to the shoulder seams. So before I sew the side seams, I'm gonna add that little strip of velvet for the belt and then attach the ties into the side seam as well. So I'm just gonna measure from side seam to side seam, which is 18 inches, as you can see. All right, so we got our little belt piece going. So I just sewed across the top and pinned it in place so it stays put in order for me to sew the side seams. And so now I'm gonna go ahead and attach these ties. I'm gonna leave the bottom edge undone because it's going to be part of the waist seam anyway. Okay, so now that I've got the belt and the ties done, and the bodice is pretty much done, just have to do the sleeves, which I'll work on tomorrow. But last thing I'm gonna do tonight is to cut out the rectangles for the skirt. Like I said, it's gonna be a super basic rectangle skirt. So the longest one, the green one, is going to be 21 inches, and then it's gonna have the little 2-inch ruffle at the bottom of the velvet. And the outer skirt is gonna be about 17 inches long, and it's gonna have the pom-pom trim at the bottom. But we'll work on that, the trim and stuff, tomorrow. Like I said, I'm just gonna cut out and I will see you tomorrow. All right, so it's day two and this is the day of the performance, so we definitely have to get it done today. Last night I did cut out the two skirts and I did some gathering stitches or basting stitches across the top just to go ahead and prep for gathering the skirts, and I added a little bit of trim on the outer skirt, which I'll show you here. Oh, and I also cut out the sleeves as well. Here's what the outer skirt is looking like. I added the gathering stitch last night, like I mentioned, and also added this gold shimmery ribbing as a trim for the front of the skirt. I think it'll be a nice complement to the gold buttons later. Okay, and now I'm gonna start on the pom-pom trim. Just clipping in place before we venture over to the machine that sews. All right, the outer skirt is ready to go.
Okay, there's much to see. Moving on.
The bottom ruffles are up next and took 5 years to do. Don't worry, I'll spare you. I am pretty proud of how they came out though. They were made by folding 4-inch wide strips in half lengthwise. I used 4 strips total. This method was easier because the velvet doesn't iron very well. So doing a rolled hem, I don't even want to imagine. They really turned out nice. I like how ruffly they are. And of course, they were finished with a top stitch.
Okay, so I've got about an hour and a half before I have to go and pick up the girls. I will have a little bit of time, maybe about an hour after I pick them up if I need it to work on things, but all that's really left is to attach the skirt onto the bodice and put some buttons on and do the sleeves. So right now I'm kind of trying to decide or weigh my options on whether I want to put the underskirt on the bodice first and then put the outer skirt like flip it up and sew it around there and then bring it down. Like if you do that, should I put it on like that, or like gather the skirts, sew them together, and then put them onto the bodice? But I feel like if I sew the outer one on first, it will be a little less moving parts, you know, because both of them need to be gathered, and that would be two layers of gathered fabric, and then the inside, the seam might be a little too bulky. So what I think I'm gonna do is put the inner skirt on first, and then put the other one so it goes like that. And I think it'll help with the overall look. I'm giving it like a little more volume anyway, since the way they're cut, they're just basic rectangles, so they don't have like a whole lot of body, but at least that will help make it look a little fuller. And yeah, so let's get started.
So here's the longest skirt. So like I said, I already did the gathering stitches last night. So what I'm gonna do is gather it and attach it to the bodice. For the center front of this skirt, I kind of wanted it to be a little flatter, or I wanted it to not have any gathers, and just to save the gathers for the sides and back of the skirt. Alrighty, and so now off to the sewing machine. I will say, I don't mind working with flannel. I kind of feel like this is the first time I've ever worked with flannel now that I think about it. But it was pretty good. It was a nice fabric to work with. Definitely beginner friendly for sure. You know, and at this point, I really kind of started panicking because almost half the day was up and I needed this dress to be completely finished by tonight. So it's like you can see the dress is just about done, but there's still so many pieces missing. It low-key felt like being on one of those like Next in Fashion type shows. All right, so now I'm gonna move on to the outer skirt, and like I said, I'm gonna understitch it. That is the term I was trying to get. I'm gonna understitch it. I may top stitch it, I'm not really sure. I'm understitching because I want it to be fuller, so we'll see. And so I decided to start with the back just to make sure that everything was even. Well, so I had to take it to the car.
Okay, so I've got everything done. Last thing to do is the sleeves. So that shouldn't take much time, and I have exactly 1 hour to do it. Oh, and you can see how it fits on Gab. It's coming together.
So a quick rundown of the sleeves. We're gonna do a gathering stitch across the top that will give it that cute puffy sleeve look. And then I'm going to hem up the bottom and just run that through the serger and then flip that up, press it, sew it down. So that way we don't have to worry about it. And then we can move on to doing the little, making the channel for the elastic so that it's nice and scrunchy. So essentially what I did was the same thing as the belt on the bodice in the beginning. I measured the width of the sleeve at the area that we wanted to put the elastic and cut out some tiny little strips just wide enough to fit the elastic freely and stitch those down on both sides. I went ahead and used this handy dandy tool. I forget what it's called. I think it's like a bobkin or something. But anyway, I used that to pull the elastic through the channel. And usually you would like pre-cut the length of the elastic, but I don't really know because I don't have the measurements for it. So the game plan is to just cut the elastic and then I'm gonna sew one end of it and then I'm gonna test it on Gabby. Whatever length is comfortable for her, that's what I'm gonna cut it to and then stretch it out and sew it to the other side. So you can see right here, I secured it on one side and then I'm gonna go test the sleeve on Gabby real quick to see what is comfortable for her. And then I just stitch that down in place. then just secure the other end of the elastic to the other side of the sleeve. And that's it for the scrunchy cuff. And the next step is to just sew the sleeve edges together. And then we'll go ahead and gather the top of the sleeve and then attach it to the bodice. And so at this point, it was definitely crunch time. I had to go get myself ready and my two babies to get out of the door on time so that she can rehearse before her recital. So I did not film sewing the sleeves on, but it's just like any other sleeve pretty much. Here's a quick clip of Gabby playing the violin. It was so cute. All right, and I'm sure you're ready to see the finished look, so here it is. Thank you guys so much for watching. You should definitely consider subscribing if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.